Hi guys, welcome back. Today I am so excited because I'm going to share with you guys how I shave my face. And also, let's address the elephant in the room. I have a new background finally. I moved in all of my makeup this past weekend into my new house, and this is what everything looks like. I don't know if it's permanent. Let me know what you guys think of this background. If you like it, I'll keep it. If not, I'll switch some things around. But I will do an updated beauty room tour for you guys once I get a little more situated in here. I still want to decorate and I want to get a couple new furniture pieces. But for now, this is what we're working with. So let me know what you think. But yeah, today I'm going to show you guys step by step and I'm going to walk you through how I shave my face. I have been doing this for so long. I don't even know for how long, but for a while, and it's a game changer. Your skin is going to be so soft like a baby's butt. Your skincare is going to go on better. Your makeup's going to look smoother. Do it at your own risk, of course, and I promise your hair is not gonna grow back thick, black, long. You're not gonna have a beard. That's a myth. So something to keep in mind. So don't be scared to do it. It's painless, it's easy, and the only thing that you're gonna get out of this is some smooth baby butt skin. I like to do this probably like once or twice a month because it's a really great way to exfoliate and get rid of dead skin. So I'm gonna show you guys, like I said today, exactly how I do it. So hope you guys enjoy. Definitely grab a snack. And let's get into it. Okay, so a couple of things to note when you're gonna shave your face. So first, you do wanna make sure that you are cleansing with something super gentle just to, you know, get rid of any dirt, old makeup that you have on your skin. So today I used the Pixi Hydrating Milky Cleanser. I believe you can get this at Target or at Ulta as well. So this is what it looks like. It's super gentle, just something really lightweight. And then you wanna go in with a toner. I've seen some people use alcohol. Personally, I can't imagine putting alcohol on my face because it's just way too drying. It's just too much. But you know, do whatever works for you, whatever you think is best for your skin. I love this Quinn's Witch Hazel. It's unscented, has no alcohol in it, and you can get it on Amazon. It's really great. Honestly, any toner, any cleanser will work, just anything to get rid of any excess makeup or like any dirt that you may have on your skin. So these are just the two that I use today, and I just use this on a cotton pad. I love Witch Hazel. It works really well with my skin. I know a lot of people don't like to use it, but again, just do whatever works well for you. So you let that dry and then you can go in and start shaving. So I like the Tinkle Eyebrow Razors. You can also get these on Amazon. These are amazing. They're super affordable. I get these in bulk because they are so affordable. I only use my razors 2 to 3 times because then after that, I feel like the blade is just not really great and you're honestly just scratching your face at that point. So 2 to 3 uses and then I just recycle them. I recommend recycling just because it is plastic. So we don't want to be wasteful. And between uses, I do sanitize the blade with alcohol. Once you're done, you can just take more of the Witch Hazel, kind of go through your skin a little bit with that, and then moisturize and just use your favorite moisturizer. We'll get to that in the end. But yeah, skin is all prepped, ready to go. Now we can get started shaving the face. So you guys probably can't even see any of my peach fuzz, but hopefully when I'm taking everything off, you can see what I'm doing. So let's do it. Comes with a little like cap on it as well. So once you're done, clean it off with an alcohol pad and then just put the cap back on. So whenever you do this, I recommend holding your skin and just pulling it a little bit taut like this and do really tiny little strokes. Don't be really hard, heavy-handed with it. Just be really, really light. If you have any cuts, any acne, cystic acne, anything on your face, do not go over it with this because you don't wanna open anything up that could potentially bleed and, you know, then you're just gonna be spreading bacteria all over your face. So if you have a pimple, if you have anything, just do not go over it. We don't want any blood here. We just wanna get rid of the beach fuzz and the dead skin. So don't go over anything that isn't smooth on your face. All right, so typically I usually start on my cheek area, so I'm gonna just, hopefully you guys can see this. Let me try to put the brightness down a little bit more. Ew. Do you guys see that? There's so much hair on this. Okay, I don't know if you can really see that, hopefully, but that is what it looks like. There's some peach fuzz on there, but that's just the beginning. Let's keep going on the rest of the face. Do you see that? Right there. That is what these take off. Disgusting, I know, but kind of satisfying at the same time if you're doing it on your own. I mean, you're probably like, girl, why are you showing us that? But I want to show you guys that even though my skin might look smooth, it's really not. I get random chin hairs right here, so I definitely like to get the chin area. And I have blackheads and stuff, don't judge me. We don't judge here. Your skin might be a little red if you're a little bit more sensitive, but it's totally fine. It's gonna go away, especially if you're like pulling at it and you know, it's fine. Always go down in downward motion when you're doing it. The only time I really go up is in certain parts of my face, like my chin, jawline kind of thing. The peach fuzz is so light. I don't know if you guys can really see it. The peach fuzz on my face isn't really like dark, but as I'm wiping, there's stuff on the wipe, so. And when you're doing this, you don't want to go deep into your skin. You're really basically just like scratching yourself. You know what I mean? So you don't want to cut yourself. Like I said, we're not here to like draw blood or be harsh on our skin. We're just here to remove dead skin and peach fuzz. So I kind of just like to feel the face and it's feeling already so much softer. I wish you guys could touch it, but like it feels really good. And then just have a mirror handy that way you can kind of see any areas that you might've missed. All right, now let's do the nose. Be very gentle in this area. Now what I'm gonna do my forehead and my brows. So with my brows, I have a little trick. I mean, I didn't come up with it or anything. I'm sure other people do it as well. But I like to outline my brows with my brow pencil, basically just like outline them like I normally would. I always outline my brows and then fill them in. So I am following along with my natural brow shape and I'm just using my ColourPop Precision brow pencil, which is my fave. And I like to do this to avoid over shaving my brows because we've all been there. Okay, middle school brows. When I go in with my razor, I'm gonna just go right around where I outlined. And it's just gonna prevent you from having them too thin or, you know, making some mistakes. This is kind of like a guide for when you're shaving around that area. I haven't actually gotten my brows done in years. I used to get them waxed every 2 weeks. Now I just do it myself because it's easier and I feel like they look better versus when I used to get them waxed every 2 weeks. I was like consistent with it, like, girl, no.
So you want to be really gentle when you're doing this, obviously, because you don't want to overshave the brows. When doing the middle of my brows, I just do kind of like the tip, just because again, I don't want to do that because I don't want to take away the inner part of my brows. And then when I do underneath, I kind of like pull that area and get those hairs there as well.
I'm gonna use tweezers to get those really stubborn little hairs. All right, now the forehead. Be careful that you don't get like all up in your hairline, you know. So I like to really like pull my hair back and make sure you don't cut any baby hairs because I've heard that they're really hard to grow back. I've never done that, but just something to keep in mind. Okay, that is pretty much it. I'm gonna go in with some more toner. You could also use a warm washcloth and go over it with a little bit of water as well. And last but not least, I'm gonna go ahead and moisturize. I'm using this one from It Cosmetics, which is my current favorite. This is my daytime moisturizer. I love this in the morning. So I'm just gonna take this and just massage this into the skin. Oh, it's really soft, you guys. It feels so good. Your skin might be red. That's totally normal, like I said, because you are pulling at it and everything. So don't be alarmed. It will go away. So that is it for this step-by-step tutorial on how I shave my face. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I know it was super simple, probably a little boring, but hopefully it was satisfying and helpful if any of you guys are looking into doing this. Like I said earlier, do it at your own risk, but I definitely recommend it. It's like you get fresh skin and your products are just gonna go on so smooth over top. If you guys do this on the regular, please leave me any of your go-to product recommendations for shaving, exfoliating your face down below in the comments. And that is it. Thank you for being here. I love you guys. Don't forget to subscribe before you leave, and I will see you very soon in my next video.